It's time for a new year, which can only mean one thing. It's time to predict NXT New Year's Evil 2022. That's right, NXT coming with a splash, giving their big event the first Tuesday of the year. Going to give the match card, going to give my predictions for this show as well. Thank you for watching SCW. Please like, share, and subscribe as well. Let's make 2022 the year of SCW, and let's see if we can get this channel to monetization. That is the goal for 2022. But enough about me and enough about the channel. Let's talk about NXT 2.0 and let's talk about New Year's Evil. I'm looking forward to this show. There's some great matches lined up, including a title unification match. We've got superstars from Raw that are going to be in-house as well to work with the young talent. So there's lots to look forward to. And to top it all off, we've got NXT Women's Championship match as well as an NXT Championship match. So lots to dive into. Let's start with that championship unification match. We've got the North American Championship against the Cruiserweight Championship. The Cruiserweight Championship will be no more. It's Carmelo Hayes, the guy that does not miss, and we've got him going against Roderick Strong. Of course, Diamond Mine probably will be around ringside, certainly Malcolm Bivens anyway, but Trick Williams, no doubt, is always in Carmelo's corner as well. Just a quick note on the Cruiserweight Championship. I'm sad that it is not going to remain in NXT, but it does feel like for quite a while now, it's not been on WWE's priority. For me, I would have liked to have seen it as a championship that could continue amongst all three brands, or certainly amongst Raw and SmackDown. There are superstars that are probably on those brands that could be a great Cruiserweight champion that could go between the shows, could be great for kickoffs on pay-per-views. But unfortunately, it got brought down to NXT. It had a good shelf life when Triple H was involved. Now it's become NXT 2.0, and pretty much every Cruiserweight that was on the books has been released. It's not really got much purpose anymore. Even at the last, well, not even TakeOver now, the War Games, it was against Joe Gacy, who was someone that is nowhere near a Cruiserweight. So I guess in a way it kind of makes sense, and it does free up an opportunity if WWE wants to introduce a new championship further down the line in NXT 2.0. But let's talk about the match at hand. The North American Championship is what the prize is at the end of this. Roderick Strong has said that it will be the happiest day of his life to become a two-time North American champion. I do not think this will happen. Of course, we're pushing the new faces, the young guard here, and Carmelo Hayes, you know, he shoots, he does not miss. Well, I expect he continues to not miss at the start of 2022. Carmelo Hayes will be my prediction. We've got a six-man tag team match. We've got Riddle from Raw, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, teaming up with MSK. Of course, Riddle is the Shaman, and a particular Imperium, which will include Volta in that lineup. Looking forward to this six-man tag team match, because in-ring, it's absolutely fantastic, the talent's on display. Since MSK have lost those tag team championships to Imperium at Halloween Havoc, they've been on this journey for the Shaman. For me, I've not really been as invested in that part of the storyline, but Riddle is a nice touch, and you can see where the link is together with them. It is quite funny, and it's quite cool to see them as a tag team, or a six-man team, shall we say, on NXT 2.0 this upcoming week of New Year's Evil. Imperium, well, the mat is sacred. They totally represent completely something different. So there is a natural good flow here for these two to have great chemistry in the ring because of the different styles and different representation. But to go in what I think the natural story of this match is, it's really based around those NXT Tag Team Championships. I don't expect Riddle or Volta to be included in the finish of this match. And usually I wouldn't bet against Volta, but today I'm going to, because I think MSK, one of them will pin one of either Marcel Bartel or Fabian Aichner, and that will put them back in the hunt to go for those NXT Tag Team Championships. So for that reason, I'm going for Riddle and MSK to pick up the victory, and I wouldn't be surprised if this match kicked off the evening. Well, I mentioned Riddle coming from Raw. AJ Styles also coming from Raw as well, but AJ Styles is not going to be in a match at the time of recording. He's coming to confront Grayson Waller. Now, I'm enjoying what they're doing with this, because AJ Styles helping the young guard. Now, people may say, well, look, you bring Riddle in, you bring AJ Styles in, desperate for a ratings pop, NXT failing. Do you know what? It probably is to help the ratings. That's not to go against that. But how about actually to pass on some wisdom, actually to work in the ring with someone with great experience like an AJ Styles? You can't pass that opportunity up. That's phenomenal for a talent like Grayson Waller. Think how that could help and benefit his career for time, years to come. He could be looking back and going, that was something that really taught me these things, changed the game for me, and took me to the next level. And then I went on from strength to strength and made myself a top star in WWE, because that's pretty much what we've got here. We've got Riddle doing that in amongst the six-man tag team match. We've got AJ Styles here doing it with Grayson Waller. Grayson Waller, he's detestable. He's someone you cannot like, and do you know what? He's been given some great momentum as a heel as of late. He's had the program with LA Knight. Of course, he jumped off the cage in War Games. He was the one that wrote Johnny Gargano out of NXT, and now he's in this program with AJ Styles, and I tell you what, it's working. It's working so well for Grayson Waller because he's getting booed each and every week. And if this does, and when it does, I think it should turn into an eventual match, whether it's, you know, on this show or whether it's another week. For me, Grayson Waller doesn't even need the win to keep that heat and to keep that momentum. He could lose to an AJ Styles and it would do no harm to his career at this stage, because just to share the ring with AJ Styles is such a phenomenal moment, and the pun is intended there. This is great for Grayson Waller, and I think it's a very bright future. And tell you what, how lucky that this talent can work with someone as world-class as AJ Styles. I'm not sure fully where the direction is going to go with this, other than it creating a match, perhaps for even on that show. We'll have to wait and see how it's going to go. Next, let's talk about the NXT Women's Championship match, which of course is a triple threat match. Mandy Rose defending against Cora Jade and Raquel Gonzalez. Oh, how it so easy could have been Io Shirai and Kaylee Ray after this past week at NXT. But how did they coexist? Well, Cora Jade and Raquel Gonzalez didn't really, did they? But they managed to find a way to pick up the victory and remain in this match. It feels natural for the storyline, in my opinion. And I do think that Mandy Rose was correct when she said at NXT, she said that the other two are so focused on winning that championship that they're going to cancel each other out and put both of themselves at the back of the line, and Mandy Rose will benefit. Mandy has more or less said how I think this match is going to go and how it will finish. So for me, at this particular moment, I don't think Mandy Rose should lose the championship. There's other people she can go up against. We've already mentioned Io Shirai. We've mentioned Kaylee Ray. There are other talents as well in the NXT women's locker room that could get an opportunity. So for me, Mandy Rose's title reign is nowhere near ready to end as of yet. So she will retain the championship, in my opinion. I think a program with her and Cora Jade will continue going forward. Cora Jade has been pushed so well in recent weeks, to the point she's picked up very big victories, even picking up the win in War Games. Raquel Gonzalez, in my opinion, I think she's ready for perhaps going to SmackDown, maybe perhaps going to Raw, maybe showing up in the Royal Rumble. I wonder if this could be her swan song. Remember, last year at New Year's Evil, she picked up another one of those big victories on the road to becoming the NXT Women's Champion in defeating Rhea Ripley. Could she do it 2 years in a row? I'm predicting not. I think what felt for Rhea Ripley last year as a swan song before moving on to Raw and to the Royal Rumble, I think this could be exactly the same this year for Raquel Gonzalez. So for me to pick my prediction, I think Mandy Rose picks up the victory, and I think her and Cora Jade will continue their storyline going forward. Last but certainly not least, it's the main event. It's the NXT Championship. Tommaso Ciampa against Bron Breakker. It is basically NXT Black and Gold against NXT 2.0. And it's a rematch as well. We had this at Halloween Havoc. Tommaso Ciampa winning that first match between the two in October. Then Bron Breakker getting the revenge, getting a pinfall on Ciampa in War Games in December. This now is the rubber match, if you want. Of course, the War Games was 4-on-4, but hey, they've got a pinfall apiece. And it feels to me this is the place where NXT 2.0 takes the full center stage here, has the championship as well, pushing that superstar to the moon. It is the right place, it is the right time to get behind Bron Breakker. Tommaso Ciampa has done great since NXT 2.0, if you want, has been reformed, repackaged, holding that brand together. Now you know that he's not going to be a long-term champion. It's time to give that belt to Bron Breakker and see what he can do with it. Will he sink, or will he swim? Personally, for me, I think Bron Breakker will swim. I think he's got many opponents he can face in NXT 2.0, and I think Tommaso Ciampa, on the other hand, has many stars he can make in NXT 2.0. But no doubt about it, this should be a great match. I'm looking forward to it. But yes, the era of Bron Breakker begins at New Year's Evil. So that's my predictions, that's my thoughts. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you for watching SCW as always. Have a happy new year. New videos will be on the way as well. Some big videos going into the month of January. So lots of reasons to subscribe to this channel. We're getting into Royal Rumble season. It's one of my favorite periods of the year. So yeah, get yourselves involved. Subscribe, share with a friend. Let them know that SCW is here. Let's make 2022 the year of SCW. Let's get it to monetization. But that's all from me anyway. Thank you for watching. Have yourselves a great day. Like I say, happy new year. Enjoy New Year's Evil. And then check out these other videos on the side of the screen right about now. I've been Steve. Thank you for watching SCW. Have yourselves a good one. And I'll see you next time.